Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel, and today it's going to be a quick short video. It's going to be another unboxing, something which many subscribers of this channel prefer to watch and enjoy. And today what I have are a bunch of trade paperbacks and some single issues that I ordered some time back. So I'm just going to start unboxing them in front of you and show what's in store. Let's get right to it. So these are the comics that I got from this package. The package is good. It had a cardboard box, as you guys could see right earlier, and it was a very thick one, so it held the books very well, and then it had bubble wrapping, right? Two most important things to keep your comics shipped safely. So thanks to the person sending it, he did a great job. Let's get right into this comics. I'll talk first around this graphic novel / trade paperbacks, and then we will talk about the singles. So very small set of comics. The first one I have is Gotham Central. It's the issue number 4 in Gotham Central, as you guys can see. Gotham Central is something which I've been very interested to collect for some time. I know it's not a mainstream Batman comic at all, but it talks about the stories of the cops in Gotham, and it brings elements of Gotham outside of Batman, right? How does this cops deal with the normal villains in Gotham and the super villains, and how Batman being around them, what kind of psychological effect it has on the cops, and so on and so forth. So it's pretty engrossing read, and I think it's a good book to pick up if you are a Batman fan and you love some great stories, right? You can get closer to where the action is. This is the first one in that line. It's called In the Line of Duty, and you can see a bunch of officers there. And the interesting part is it does not have Commissioner Gordon or Harvey Bullock, who are the mainstream cops there, but it has a set of other cops. So this is the number 1 of Gotham Central, and now I have number 4. So I have two of them right now, and if I find them a good read, I plan to get the rest of Gotham Central's as well. I think I love this artwork. It has that old art feel to it, and I love the newspaper print quality of the pages, which is something which I personally admire. So very happy to get this, and if found interesting, I'm definitely sure that I'm going to get more of Gotham Central in the days to come. The next one which I have is an interesting one. It's a Vertigo comic. I don't have much of Vertigo comic, and this is Stieg Larsson's The Girl with the Dragon Tattoo. Obviously it's in regards to the movie with the same name, which is a pretty famous movie, and I've heard quite a bit about this book and the great art that it contains, and that's the reason why I picked it up. My plan is, obviously I'm expecting this to be an engaging read, and you can see it already with the kind of art it has. So if it does appeal to me, then I plan to collect more of this entire series, because this is only part 1. There is also a part 2 to complete this one, and then there are spin-offs around the girl who kicked the hornet's nest and so on and so forth, right? So this is going to be a good start. This is where you start reading stuff that you normally have not read, and then you want to try things out, and I thought this is a good place to start, right? It is a crime fiction story, and I simply love those kind of stories, so that's why I picked it up. So yeah, I would read this and come back to you and give you guys a full review on how I felt about this one, and if I did, I'm pretty certain that I'll be picking more of this. So those were the graphic novels / trade paperbacks in this collection. The next ones are some singles, and I picked up some of them mostly for its cover art. I'm not going to go in deep into what this comic contains. So this one is Year of the Villain Nightwing number 62, The Offer. I love the talent cover here. I think it's done by Capullo. Yeah, so Greg Capullo is one of my favorites, and that's the reason why I picked up this variant cover. I'm not a Nightwing fan, and I don't think this story will appeal to me too much, but I just bought it for the cover. And again, this one is a new, it came very recently. It's called The Batman's Grave, number one. This is the first issue. And again, this is a brilliant, cover art. Again, that's the reason why I picked it up. I plan to read the entire Batman's Grave in the trade paperback or a hardcover. This one I just bought for the really cool cover that it has. So what else did I get? I got some Phantoms, and it's always great picking up Phantoms other than the Regal ones. So this is the old DC Phantoms, and I've had some of this in the past. I sold it off or I gave it to somebody and stuff like that. So when I got a chance to get more of them, I went ahead and bought it. So this has the 89 DC published Phantom issues 1 to 3. So earlier I only got, I think, one issue, and I had a break, but this one has continues 1, 2 and 3. So, and that's the reason why I bought it. The first two issues are good. The third one has little bit of water damage, I could see. But still, it's a good pickup. And from Phantom, you move to, again, Batman. This is Batman versus Predator. And this is kind of like a crossover between DC and Dark Horse. And I love the way Batman is portrayed here, and Predator is here. So yeah, I prefer to collect this also in the form of a trade paperback someday with the crossover. And the final book that I have around all this is Dark Knight's Metal. This is number one. And I had this issue with me already, but the difference is this is a director's cut. So of recent times, I've been getting more of director's cut, which is more like a, the good part is this will have all the variant covers. It has the story, but the story isn't actually in black and white as thought out by the artist, before the coloring has been laid on. So you can see the black and white, which brings out the true nature of how the artist was thinking when he put down this story arc. And then it has the variant covers, right? So again, this is not something which I'm just showing you some quick snapshot. I like some great, it has some great covers that in here. And I'm a big fan of Scott Snyder and Greg Capullo. Their Batman run was something which brought me back into comics, and that's the reason why I love them more than many others. So again, Dark Knight Metal has some great cover gallery, and I'm yet to pick up the main story arc in the hardcover or trade paperback, which I will do so, but until then I have some singles to read through and get the synopsis. But a great collection, add to my collection this one. That's Dark Knight's Metal. So guys, those were the books that I got in this video. I hope you liked and enjoyed it. If you did, please do consider subscribing, and just wait it out for the next haul. Bye-bye.